नॉन होमोजीनियस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन होमोजीनियस एंड नॉन होमोजीनियस, देयर इज ओनली एंड ओनली डिफरेंस बिटवीन द होमोजीनियस एंड नॉन होमोजीनियस इज ऑफ द कॉन्स्टेंट ओनली, राइट. सो वी हैव ओनली एंड ओनली वन डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू, दैट इज ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट. सो इफ देर इज नो कॉन्स्टेंट देन दिस इक्वेशन विल ऑल्सो बिकम द होमोजीनियस, राइट. सो डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ नॉन होमोजीनियस कैन बी रिटर्न इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए वन एक्स प्लस बी वन वाई प्लस सी वन डिवाइडेड बाई ए टू एक्स प्लस बी टू वाई, ए टू एक्स प्लस बी टू वाई प्लस सी टू. ओके, सो दिस इज अ नॉन होमोजीनियस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. हाउ वी कैन अप्रोच द नॉन होमोजीनियस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, लेट मी शो यू डियर स्टूडेंट्स. डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन इज ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ इज ऑफ दिस फॉर्म इज सेट टू बी नॉन होमोजीनियस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉन्स्टेंट्स ओनली. नाउ वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट, वी हैव टू ट्रांसफॉर्म नॉन होमोजीनियस इक्वेशन इन टू द होमोजीनियस, राइट. सो हाउ वी कैन अप्रोच विद द हेल्प ऑफ नॉन होमोजीनियस टू द होमोजीनियस, आई विल शो यू. देर आर टू केसेज पॉसिबल, ओके, लेट मी राइट डाउन. देर आर टू केसेज पॉसिबल एंड एक्चुअली ईच एंड एवरी थिंग इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द कोफिशियंट्स, मीन्स ए वन बी वन एंड ए टू बी टू. ओके, सो लेट मी टेल यू, देर आर टू केसेज. सो केस नंबर वन विल बी वॉट इफ ए वन बी एक्स, राइट. यू वी हैव कोफिशियंट्स, यू कैन सी हियर ए वन बी टू, ए वन b1, a2 and b2, right. So if a1 b2 minus b2 a1, a1 b2 minus a2 b1, a1 b2 minus a2 b1 can be equals to 0, and the second case when if a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is not equals to 0, we have only two cases, right. What exactly this is, a1 is the coefficient of x, b1 is the coefficient of y, a2 is the coefficient of x, sorry, right, and b2 is the coefficient of y again. So in the numerator and denominator we are having constants. So when if it is not equals to 0, how we will approach, and when it is equals to 0, how we will approach. So first let me show you about not equals to 0. Okay, let me write down here not equals to 0 and if it is equals to 0. If it is not equals to 0, dear students, then you will substitute. You will substitute at the place of small x, capital X plus h, and the place of small y, you will substitute capital Y plus k. If your a1 b2 minus, you can see easily, a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is not equals to 0, right? a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is not equals to 0, you will substitute at the place of x in the given equation, capital X plus h, and small y will be capital Y plus k, where k is a substitution which we have to find out. Okay, where k is the value which we have to find out, dear students. So where h and k are the values which we have to find out. So let me write down, h and k are constants which we have to find out, h and k are constants which we will find out, okay, which we will get by solving the equation. Okay, you can say small x is equals to capital X plus h, small y is equals to capital Y plus k, where h and k are constant which we have to determine and which we have to find out. Okay, the first form is this one. In the second form, if you get, dear students, a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equals to 0, it means definitely there is something common in the numerator or denominator. That common portion will be your substitution only. So there is no need to put any extra thing. Okay, whenever you have a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equals to 0, you can easily identify either in the numerator or denominator, definitely there is a part which is common in numerator and denominator both. So that common part will be work as a substitution only. So let me write down the language for this one. So in that one, then some part of the numerator, then some part of the numerator or denominator, my dear students, some part of numerator or denominator some part of the numerator or denominator yes if we have a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equals to 0, then we can say the sum part of the numerator or denominator are equal, okay, are equal, and that equal part will be your substitution only, and that equal part दैट इक्वल पार्ट विल बी योर सब्स्टिट्यूशन ओनली, विल बी योर सब्स्टिट्यूशन ओनली, राइट. आई विल शो यू विद द एग्जाम्पल, डोंट वरी फॉर दैट. आई विल अप्रोच यू ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. दीज आर एग्जैक्टली वेरी वेरी सिंपल टू गो डियर स्टूडेंट्स. द फर्स्ट थिंग विच यू कैन सी दैट इफ योर ए वन बी टू माइनस ए टू बी वन इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, यू कैन डायरेक्टली पुट स्मॉल एक्स इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एक्स प्लस एच, स्मॉल वाई इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल वाई प्लस के. द सेकेंड थिंग, इफ यू आर हैविंग ए वन बी टू माइनस ए टू बी वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, देन डेफिनेटली इन द न्यूमरेटर और डिनोमिनेटर देर इज एनीथिंग कॉमन, ओके, एंड दैट कॉमन पार्ट विल बी सब्स्टिट्यूशन. Now, I will show you questions, dear students, but before that, let me tell you one important thing, that till now, in the GET examination, there is not at all a single question has been asked in the GET examination about that you have to solve the non-homogeneous equation. There are questions always comes from this concept, is only and only find the substitution for the non-homogeneous equation. Because when we substitute the things, first of all we have to find the substitution in these type of question, then we substitute the things in the given differential equation, then we have to solve with the help of homogeneous, that is y is equals to vx or x is equals to vy. So it will become a very very lengthy question. So these type of questions can ask in your engineering examination means your semester examination, but these type of questions will never asked in the GET examination, okay. Although I will tell you one question to approach, but there is no need to go with this one, okay. So we have to find only substitution. The question framed till now, and it will not frame, definitely it will not frame for the solution of non-homogeneous. So questions can frame only and only for finding the substitution, only and only for finding the substitution portion only, right? Substitution portion only, right? I will show you with the examples. Let's have discussion. So we have some examples we can easily approach, and how to approach this one. So the question can be framed like this: find the substitution to change from non-homogeneous to homogeneous. So let's approach with the first example. So when we approach it, it will be dy by dx is equals to x plus 2y minus 3 divided by 2x plus y minus 3. Yes, exactly. Now what we have to do, we have to just consider the thing that either a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equals to 0 or not 0. Let's approach the question, guys. Now let's approach the first question. Here we can see the a1 is equals to 1, yes, b1 is equals to 2, a2 is equals to 2, and b2 is equals to 1. We can say a1 b2, that is 1, minus a2 b1, that is equals to minus 4, which is not equals to 0. It means this is the question of case 1. Yes, we can find substitution with the help of x plus h and y plus k. So we can put here small x is equals to capital X plus h and small y is equals to capital Y plus k, right? Now how we will find the values of h and k, I will show you a method, okay. How we can find the value of h and k, I will show you a different method so that easily you can approach to the value of h and k. Now what you have to write down, dear students, you have to do only one thing, that just look at the equation. You have to write down h here, k here, and 1 here. H is denoting the x, y is denoting the k is denoting the y, and 1 is denoting the coefficient. Means below the h you have to write down the coefficient of x in the numerator and denominator. You can see the coefficient of x is 1 only in the numerator, and in the denominator it is 2, okay, right? Yes, exactly, you can see, okay. Yes, so here this is h and k and 1. We are having each and everything. For the k, we can consider the coefficient of y only. So we have to write down the coefficient of y from the numerator and denominator both. It will be 2. It will be 1 only. For the constant, we will write down minus 3 and minus 3 only, right? So with the help of Cramer rule or with the help of this approach, we have to find the value of h, k and 1. How? You have to write down here h is equals to k is equals to 1, okay? Let's approach for the h. When we have to find the value of h, we will not consider the line, the row and column of h. It's a similar to determinate concept. It will be minus 6, yes, exactly. When we multiply this one, minus minus plus 3, yes, exactly. Okay, now let's approach to the k only. For the k, okay, you have two options. Either you can go with the different direction, but I will go with the same direction always. So that's why I will put here minus k, right? So just similar to the determinate concept. For the k, I will go with the same direction, means 1 into minus 3 will be there. If you don't want to write down the negative, then you have to first find the value of minus 3 into 2. Then you will approach 1 into minus 3. But I used to go with the same concept because what we did in the edge, we followed the first arrow, this one, 2 into minus 3. Then we followed this one. The same arrow I will follow for the k also. I will go for k 1 into minus 3. It will be minus 3, yes. Minus 3 into 2. It will be minus minus plus 6. Yes, exactly. Okay. And I already put it k negative sign in front of k. So for the 1 constant, we will approach the same direction, 1 into 1, 1, and 2 into 2 is 4. So 1 minus 4 is there, yes, exactly. So with the help of this one, we can find the coefficient directly, guys. So it will be, you can say it will be h is equals to minus k is equals to 1. We will have minus 3, we will have 3, and we will have minus 3. So we can say we are having minus 3 minus 3 also. So h is equals to minus 3 by minus 3, which is equals to 1. So you can say h is equals to 1, yes. Hence also we will get k is equals to 1, yes. So we are having the substitution, right? H and k, when we are having, so the substitution which we have to find out, we can say the substitution will be x plus 1 and the substitution will be y plus 1. Means these will be your substitution. It means, dear students, if in the given equation you will substitute at the place of a small x, capital X plus 1, and at the place of a small y, if you substitute capital Y plus 1, your equation, which is exactly now non-homogeneous, will convert into the homogeneous form. Then you can approach accordingly, right? If you want, then I will show you how it is a non-homogeneous to homogeneous. We can say it will become, right, dx is equals to dy only. Yes, exactly. It will be x at the place of x. We can write down x plus 1. It will be 2y plus 2 minus 3 divided by 2x plus 2. Yes. Plus y plus 1 minus 3. You can see here. 2 plus 1 is 3 and 3 and minus 3 will be cancelled out. 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 and minus 3 will be cancelled out. So definitely you are having here, okay, it was in the dy by dx form. So we can say, when it was in the dy by dx form, it is now x plus 2y, yes, divided by 2x plus y. Now this is your homogeneous equation. You can see here, the degree will be 1, 1, degree will be 1, 1. So that's why this is a homogeneous equation. So now you can approach the homogeneous equation in the form of y is equals to vx or x is equals to vy form. Clear? So exactly there is no need to do like this, but we have to find only and only substitution, because this will be a very, very lengthy process to finding the solution by converting non-homogeneous into homogeneous, then find the solution. Okay? So definitely there will be no question asked in the GATE examination based on this concept. Right? Now let's approach to the next one. Let's approach to this one. Let's find the substitution again. So dy by dx is equals to 2x plus 2y minus 2. We are having y plus 2x minus 3. Now so many students get confused that it is equals to 2 into 2, 4 and 2. Nah, it should be in the form of that one only. So 2x, we have to write down 2x plus y minus 3 only, right? Now we will consider a1, this is a1, this is a b1, this is a2 and this is b2, right? We have one only. So 2, it will be 2 minus 4, which is not equals to 0. We can easily identify that here a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is not equals to 0. So when it is not equals to 0, we will go for what? we will go for what? We will go for the case one only. So we have we will substitute small x is equals to capital X plus h, small y is equals to capital Y plus k. Now let's find the values right here only. Let's find the values right here only, dear students. So it will be h, k and 1. Yes, exactly. So what we have to put at below the h? The h is denoting the coefficient of x in the numerator and denominator. It will be 2 and 2. Yes, it will be 2 and 2. The k is denoting the coefficient of y in numerator and denominator. It will be 2 and 1. Yes, it will be 2 and 1. And 1 is denoting the constant. It will be minus 2 and minus 3. Okay. Now let's find the substitution. So when we have to approach the substitution, it will be h is equals to k is equals to 1. Let's put already negative here in front of k. So when we approach h, it will be minus 6. Yes. Minus minus plus 2. Yes, exactly. For k, it will be minus 6. Yes. Minus minus plus 4. Okay. For 1, it will be 2 and minus 4 only. Yes, exactly. I think you are getting my point, dear students. We have to just cross multiply the things. This is called the Cramer rule only, right? So when we have to approach to the h, we have to leave the row and column of the h. So we will approach 2 into minus 3. It is minus 6. We will approach minus 2 into 1. It will be minus 2 into 1 will be minus 2. But we will always have a negative sign. So it will be minus minus plus 2, right? It will be minus minus plus 2. Yes, exactly. So similarly for k, we already put it here minus k. So it will be 2 into minus 3 will be minus 6. Minus 2 into 2, it will be minus 4. But minus minus plus 4 we will have, right? So it's just like to approach the determinant only. The similar process to the determinant only. Because we will multiply this one and after that, suppose, let me show you, it will be 2 into minus 3. Minus, it will be minus 2 into 1. So there is always a negative sign in between these two terms. In between these two terms, there is always a negative sign. So 2 into minus 3 is minus 6. Minus 2 into 1 will be minus 2. Minus minus plus 2. That's why I write down here plus 2. Okay? Clear, guys? Yes. So let's approach the solution. So it will be h by minus 4. It will be minus k by minus 2. Yes. It will be 1 by minus 2. So it will be cancelled out. So you will get h is equals to, let's approach from here h and k, value of h and k. So you will get h is equals to minus 4 by minus 2, which is equals to 2 only. Yes. And when you approach to the k, it will be minus 2 by 2 only. So it will be minus 1. For the k, you will get minus 1. And for the h, you will get, dear students, plus 2, right? So h will be plus 2 and k will be minus 1. I think you are getting my point. You are understanding how to approach the question. The similar pattern we discussed for the first one also. This is the similar question, right? We have all the four question and all the four will be similar. The pattern will be similar. You have to write down first that x is equals to x plus h and y is equals to y plus k, right? Just after checking the this thing a1 b2 minus a2 b1, either it is equals to 0 or it is not equals to 0. When it is not equals to 0, then we will go for h, k and 1 method, right? And just below the h, you have to write down the coefficient of x only. You can see the coefficient of x are 2 and 2. That's why I write down here 2 and 2. Just below the k, you have to write down the coefficient of y only. You can see here the coefficient of y are 2 and 1 only. So that's why I write down here 2 and 1 only. And the below the 1, you have to write down the coefficient, means the constant terms. Okay, then you have to approach just like the determinant. If you know how to find the determinant, you can easily approach, right? So we are doing simply multiplication for the h. We will not consider this row and this column. We will take opposite value. So it will be 2 into minus 3, that is minus 6. And there will be a negative sign always in between these two terms. When we multiply this one and this one, there will be a negative sign just in the determinant, like just like in the determinant. So it will be minus minus 2 and 1. So that's why it will be minus minus plus 2. Okay, guys, it's a very simple thing to approach. Now let's approach to the next question. Let's go for this one. Let me show you here only. Let's go for this one. Let me show you here only, guys. So what we can have for the next question. So the next question will be dy by dx is equals to x plus 2y plus 1, it will be, let me write down, it is written as y plus 2x plus 3, right? So let me write down it correctly. So 2x plus y plus 3. So you can easily understand my thing and there will be no confusion in your mind exactly. So when we approach, it will be, we have to do a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is equals to 0. Yes, exactly. This is my a1, coefficient is 1. This is my a1 b2, this is my b2. So that will be 1. 2 into 2, it will be minus minus plus 4. Okay, 2 into 2 will be 4, minus 4, it will be not equals to 0. So many students think that there will be 0. You can easily identify the question. You should not go with like this, that 1 into 2 and 2 into 1, it will be 0 for you. When you go like this, it will be 2 minus 2, it will be 0. Why? Because exactly you are multiplying the coefficient of x to the x only. You are not doing a1 b2 minus a2 b1. You are doing a1 a2 and b2 b1 only, which is wrong. So we know very well we have to consider a1 b2 minus a2 b1 only. That's why it will be not equals to 0. So let's approach it. Let's write down small x will be capital X plus h. Yes, small y will be capital Y plus k. Yes, exactly. Okay, so in the last question, what we did, what we got, small x is equals to capital X plus 2, I think, right? And small y will be capital Y minus 1, right? This was your substitution in the last question. You can easily put the value of h and k, right? It's not a different thing. So now let's approach to this one. We will approach h, k and 1 only. Yes. So below the h, what you have to write down? You have to write down the coefficient of x in the numerator and denominator. It will be 1 and 2. Coefficient of y, we have to write down below the k, it will be 2 and 1, the constant term 1 and 3, right? So let's approach with h is equals to k is equals to 1. I am already putting here negative, so that's why I don't want to change the order of the multiplication. That's why I am putting here negative. So for the h, it will be 2 into 3, 6, yes, minus 1 into 1 will be 1 only. When you go for the k, right, as I already told you, the direction will be like this. If you want to change the direction, then you have to multiply 1 into 2 first. Then it will be 2, 1 into 3 minus, it will be minus 3. Then you will get minus 1. But what I am doing, I am just multiplying first from here. So 1 will be 3, 1 into 3, it will be 3. Minus 2 into 1, it will be 2, right? So that's why I will get 1, and that's why I put it here already a negative sign. Because in each and every multiplication, we do first multiply these two terms, then we multiply these two terms. Yes, exactly. Similarly, first we multiply these two terms, means multiply 1 and 3, then we multiply 1 and 2. That's why I want, I am just taking same order. That's why I multiply here already minus, I just put it already here minus, okay? This is a simple Cramer rule which you learned in the class 11th or 12th, okay? Now let's approach to the constant k. It will be 1 into 1, 1, 2 into 2 will be 4. So it will be 1 minus 4. So when we approach it, it will be h by 5. It will be k by minus 1. It will be 1 by minus 3. Now let's find the value of the constants. So it will be h by 5 minus 5 by 3. Okay. When we approach to the k, it will be minus 1 by minus 3. So it will be 1 by 3 only. For the k, h, you will get minus 5 by 3. For the k, you will get 1 by 3. So if you want to write down the substitution, you can go for x minus 5 by 3, guys. And for the y, you can go for y plus 1 by 3, right? So I think it's clear to everyone how we can approach the questions. Now let's have a discussion on one last question based on the non-homogeneous concept. And this is a very, very simple question, right? So let's approach the last question, dear students. After that, the homogeneous and non-homogeneous, both the things are done. Okay, homogeneous and non-homogeneous, both are done after that. So it will be dy by dx. Let's write down here. X plus 2y plus 1, yes, divided by 2x plus 4y plus 1. Yes, exactly. So let's approach to this one. So we can see here, this is the a1. If you are feeling uncomfortable, you can write down the coefficient, right? So it's very simple thing. A1 is equals to 1, B1 is equals to 2. ए टू इज इक्वल टू टू एंड बी टू इज इक्वल टू फोर वी आर हैविंग. वेन वी मल्टीप्लाई ए वन इंटू बी टू माइनस ए टू इंटू बी वन इट विल बी फोर माइनस फोर हैंड्स इट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो वेन इट इज इक्वल टू जीरो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ केस नंबर वन. सो वी कैन नॉट पुट हियर स्मॉल एक्स इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एक्स प्लस एच एंड स्मॉल वाई इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल वाई प्लस के. देन वॉट वी हैव टू डू वॉट वी हैव टू डू एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इन द केस नंबर टू वैन ए वन बी टू माइनस ए टू बी वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो देर विल बी समथिंग कॉमन पार्ट देर विल बी डेफिनेटली अ कॉमन पार्ट विच यू कैन सी इन द न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर एंड दैट कॉमन पार्ट विल वर्क एज ए सब्सटीट्यूशन ओनली. लेट मी शो यू दैट कॉमन पार्ट. सो इट विल बी डी वाई बाई डी एक्स ओनली. यस वी कैन राइट डाउन इन द न्यूमरेटर इट विल बी एक्स प्लस टू वाई प्लस वन. वी कैन टेक कॉमन फ्रॉम हेयर टू इट विल बी एक्स प्लस टू वाई अगेन. यस एग्जैक्टली इट विल बी वन. सो यू कैन सी द कॉमन पार्ट विल बी दिस वन. सो यू कैन टेक सब्सटीट्यूशन एज ए एक्स प्लस टू वाई. वॉट आई ऑलरेडी सेड यू दैट देर विल बी अ कॉमन पार्ट बिटवीन न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर. यू कैन सी द कॉमन पार्ट इज एक्स प्लस टू वाई विच कम्स इन द न्यूमरेटर ऑल्सो एंड विच कम्स इन द डिनोमिनेटर ऑल्सो. सो दैट्स वाई वी कैन से द सब्सटीट्यूशन विल बी एक्स प्लस टू वाई ओनली. सो इफ क्वेश्चन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट सब्सटीट्यूशन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक दिस नॉन होमोजीनियस इक्वेशन इन टू द होमोजीनियस इक्वेशन वी हैव टू राइट डाउन जेड एट द प्लेस ऑफ एक्स प्लस टू वाई ओनली. डन. सो दैट्स ऑल फ्रॉम द होमोजीनियस एंड नॉन होमोजीनियस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन डियर स्टूडेंट्स.